Hello, today I'm going to be making a chocolatier shop using the dark brown version of the designer studio building. The original color of the designer studio is lavender from the town series, but for quite a few years now there have been at least three alternative colors of the building available. These were available as fan club limited edition colors. My favorite one is this deep, rich chocolate brown color, and two others being a turquoise color and a medium blue, both of which I will use in future setups. For the top, I added this piece from the classic red roof country home because I think it gives a Swiss chocolatier look. I had already wallpapered this at Christmas time, and I decided to keep this deep, vibrant coral wallpaper because it looks so striking against the white window frames and those jewel green doors. I use ribbon trim to dress up the windows. The embossed details on this building are so elegant. For the top floor windows, I had this fabric that I got many years ago, and I thought the colors looked perfect for the chocolatier shop. This ribbon trim looks really nice, and it would also make great trim for a rug. Next, I wanted a curved counter, so I took the pink curved counter from the country clinic and I dressed it up a bit with craft paper. The color fits in well with the room, and I used decorative tape for trim at the top. I then took this shelving unit from the interior shop. I used the decorative tape to cover the wording, and then I took this bow from the blooming flower shop to add a little more decoration at top. To display in the shelves, I found these plastic bunnies at the craft store, and they look just like chocolate bunnies at Easter time. For the glass display case, I used these gift box stickers to make it look like you can get boxed chocolates. I also added these fancy miniature Godiva chocolates. To dress up my curved countertop, I added two ice creams from the vintage ice cream cart in the Sylvanian collection, as well as a vibrant red bunny tart. I added this pink stand from the village cake shop and some additional cake stands. From the left, the first and the third are two cakes from the critter collection. A lovely display for the chocolatier's creations. On the bottom floor, I used one of my favorite pieces, the counter from the chocolate lounge. I also used this display stand from the vintage village store. However, I found it rather plain for the chocolatier shop, so I dressed it up with craft paper. Here in the counter's display case, I've added cakes and individual chocolates. This gorgeous chocolate handmade miniature I bought takes center stage. I added more gift box stickers, supposed to be filled with individual chocolates, to the other display stand. I then added more gorgeous chocolate cakes and boxes of chocolate on display. On either side at top, there's supposed to be edible gift boxes made of chocolate cake. And I also added this really cute box of chocolates there in the center from one of the older cake shops in the collection. For the elegant seating, I used the table and chairs from the Lattery set, and then to duplicate it, I took the white table that comes in the Elegant Town Manor set, which normally comes with purple chairs, and put that with the pink chairs that come with the Rose Garden Tea Party set. This flower box is a window box from the Grand Hotel, and it always comes in handy. This beautiful counter is from the Blooming Flower Shop, and it's topped with a tray full of decadent chocolate treats. I created outdoor seating with the tables and chairs from the tea and treat set, and a matching stand in the back is from a more vintage flower stall. I covered the sign from that same flower shop with a dessert sign. I then added lots more treats and details, including to the outside. So let's take a tour of the whole finished complex. I parked a bicycle on the corner for a critter who'll be visiting the ice cream cart later. And here's a small table and chairs for any critter who wants to sit down and enjoy their ice cream. The chairs are from the Sweet Party set that was released in March 2023. The set comes with cute cappuccinos. The chairs are a lovely light shade of pink. On the other corner is a bench for more seating, and I added a tray of chocolate donuts as well as an eclair from the Sweet Party set. Here we have a table set with a chocolate macaron as a starter and cups of espresso. And then we have two little cakes from the Butler set and another decadent chocolate treat. Whoever is sitting at this table is in for a treat because they've ordered the deluxe platter. It includes samples of the finest chocolates. The cherries are handmade miniatures that I had, and the strawberries come from the Toy Poodle cake decorating set. In the back, we have slices of irresistible chocolate chip cake for sale, more donuts and gift boxes, and another chocolate cake from the Critter collection. In addition to the tasty desserts, this table is set with cappuccino from the Sweet Party set. On this table is the dessert of the week, chocolate cake layered with pistachio cream. Oh, the villagers are showing up. There's Miss Forrester Dog getting ice cream for her little baby and the raccoon friend. Little Buckley Deer has arrived on her bicycle to meet her honey fox friend for ice cream. The Nettlefields are enjoying a chocolate-covered banana and a chocolate ice cream stick on this fine day. These grandmothers always tell themselves that next time they'll try a different flavor macaron, but they always end up getting the chocolate. The Norwoods are celebrating their 30th wedding anniversary. Mr. Norwood is pleased to see that the chocolatier only uses fresh cherries and strawberries grown on Mr. Norwood's farm. Ms. Marmalade shows up to pour glasses of ice-cold milk. The Norwoods request, "Leave the pitcher, please. We're gonna need it." Ms. Honeyfox is awfully tempted by that big chocolate cake. It's a busy day at the Chocolatier, and Ms. Marmalade has to rush upstairs to her cake counter. She reassures a discerning customer that indeed the chocolate is all handmade. Grandpa Snowwarn is picking out a box of Godiva chocolate for his wife, Priscilla. The toy poodle at the counter already knows it's going to be a busy afternoon with all the orders that are coming in. These critters can't tear themselves away from their conversation about fine Peruvian chocolate. These sisters are celebrating after a fine performance in their music recital today. The little one got an ice cream sandwich from the ice cream cart. Big sister is trying a chocolate bunny tart, and they're both enjoying hot cocoa with whipped cream, and they're gonna share the chocolate and pistachio cream dessert of the week. Oh my, their mother is sure to have a fit if they stain their satin dresses. Miss Simpkins has just bustled in from a hot kitchen with a tray of fine desserts. "Excuse me, sir," says the little toy poodle. "Here's the takeout box that you requested." All heads turn when the little bunny waitress wheels out the chocolate fountain. There are skewered marshmallows, bananas, and strawberries to dip. Mr. Norwood loves marshmallows, but he better not go back to the table empty-handed for Mrs. Norwood. "Another sweet for my sweetest," he says to Mrs. Norwood as he hands her a chocolate-covered strawberry. "Oh dear, where does the time go?" says Grandma Cow. "Angus surely can't be upset with me for being late now that I've bought him some chocolates." I hope you enjoyed this visit to the Chocolatier Shop. I'd like to use some variation of it again, either in a future Swiss Alpine setup or a Christmas setup.